In this lesson, we will get started with creating a custom gym environment for the inventory management problem. As you know, gym has many ready-made environments like Cartpole V1. However, there aren't any ready-made environments for real-world problems like the inventory management problem. So if no ready-made environment is available, we have to create a custom gym environment. And we can do this as long as we have defined the states, the actions, the state transition, and the reward function in the real world problem. In the previous videos, we discussed how to define these quantities for a real world problem. As an example, we defined these quantities in the inventory management problem. And here is a quick summary. The state we found consists of the current on-hand inventory, the historical actions, the mean of the demand distribution, and some other parameters in the problem. The next state is given by the expression that you see here. And just so that you can see how, given state ST and action AT, we can construct the next state, I have expressed ST plus 1 in terms of ST and AT in this second line. And in this expression, the only unknown quantity is the demand at time T, which we sample from a Poisson distribution with mean lambda. And lambda is simply the fifth element of ST. So that gives us the state transition. And once we know ST, ST plus 1, and AT, we can compute the reward obtained in the transition using this expression. And this expression was also derived in the previous videos. So that's everything that we need to know in order to code the custom gym environment. To define a custom gym environment, you need to define a class which represents your custom gym environment. I have called it inventory.env here. The class must derive from gym.env. Gym.env is a base class which defines the interface that any gym environment needs to follow. We can take a look at this base class by going to gym's GitHub repository and then choosing the tag v0.21.0, which is the pinned version that we are using, and then going to the gym folder and then going to core.py. And you can see that the base env class is defined here. The API, the main API of this class, consists of five methods, which are step, reset, render, close, and seed. Out of these, the first three are mandatory, and the last two are optional. This means that any child class must implement the first three methods. In addition, the child class must also implement the init method. So with this information, we can already create a skeleton for our inventory.env environment. So it must define an init method, and the job of this method is to define the observation space and the action space of the environment in the instance variables self.observation space and self.action space. Plus, if you need something else to initialize an instance of the environment, you can also do those initialization steps inside the init method. Next, it must have a reset method whose job is to reset the environment to its initial state so that a new episode can start. And this method should return the observation of the initial state. That is the first observation. It must define a step method which takes an action as an argument, performs one transition step, and returns the next observation, the reward obtained in the transition, whether the current observation is a terminal state, and optionally some additional info. Here, instead of writing any code, since this is just a skeleton, I have raised a non-implemented error indicating that this method must be implemented. All right, next comes the render method, which the custom environment must also implement. The job of this method is to display the current environment state, for example, the graphical window in cartpole v1, which you can see here. So this is shown when this render method is used. But it is okay to leave this method empty if you don't want to give the user an option to visualize the environment state. So I will leave it empty for now. The environment can optionally implement a close method, and the job of this close method is to clean up all the resources like threads, graphical windows, browsers, etc. that are being used by the environment instance. Finally, the environment can optionally implement a seed method. And this is used for setting seeds for all the random number generators that are being used in an environment. And this can be useful for reproducibility and testing of environments that have random behavior in their state transitions, or anywhere for that matter. So this would be also true for the inventory management environment, because we see that the state transition has needs to know the demand, and which is which follows this Poisson distribution, right? So there is a random element in the state transition. Cool. So with that, that gives us the basic skeleton. So what you see here is the basic skeleton of the inventory management environment, or any custom environment for that matter. Now we simply need to implement all of these methods. So in the next videos, I will show you how to implement these methods one by one.